Well, it's a new dawn for Qantas this morning with Alan Joyce departing the top job early following a turbulent few weeks for the airline. After 15 years at the helm, Joyce today hands over the controls to Vanessa Hudson, who's now tasked with rebuilding Qantas' plummeting reputation. It comes as the Prime Minister faces fresh demands to explain what he knew about the blocking of Qatar Airways' bid for more flights into this country and when. Let's bring in Home Affairs Minister Claire O'Neill and Shadow Finance Minister Jane Hume. Good morning to you, Claire. So, during question time, Anthony Albanese admitted discussing Qatar's application with Virgin, unaware a decision had actually been made 3 days earlier to block the extra flights from Qatar. How can the PM be so out of touch?
Oh, well, Nat, I don't think that's accurate. The reason that the PM didn't know was because it wasn't the PM's decision. It was the decision of the Transport Minister. She's entitled under Australian law to make these decisions in the national interest. I'm a minister who has some national interest powers, and this always involves weighing a bunch of complex factors. But I think what's really going on here is Australians are really fed up with a bunch of things that have been happening in aviation, and particularly the behaviour of Qantas. Mm. We've got a new CEO taking the helm of Qantas today, and they've got a really big opportunity here to reset their relationship with Australians, and I desperately hope that they take it.
Yeah, so you said the Transport Minister's role is to make decisions in the national interest. Mm. Was it in the national interest to get less Qatar flights flying in and out of this country and therefore bring down airfares and get the Australian flying public to pay less?
Nat, Qatar have lots of opportunities to bring more people in and out of the country. We've got other airlines which are increasing their flights in and out of Australia at the moment. Cathay Pacific and Singapore Airlines are in the process of doing that. What I think is really important here is to get Qantas to pick up its game.
Yeah, and we know that they've done some really cool things. The chairman has acknowledged that, and the new CEO has acknowledged that. But on to this one, you've got business figures, you've got economists, you've got people in three Labor states saying this decision would have helped the Australian flying public. So was it the Transport Minister's... was it a good decision by the Transport Minister to block Qatar?
Mm-hmm. I absolutely support her decision, Nat, and I've made that point there that we've got a number of other things happening that will increase competition in aviation, and I get that. Remember, the Australian government doesn't determine how much air flights cost in this country. We have a bunch of levers that can assist Australians with the cost of living crisis, and we're pulling those. But I would just say, again, there are lots of opportunities for Qatar to already increase the number of people that it takes in and out of Australia. It would be great to understand why they are not doing that at the moment.
But on that decision, did your government restrict competition and damage the flying public in this country?
So, Nat, the Transport Minister's made a decision. She's made a decision in the national
That's
interest.
That's what I'm talking about. I've said that decision. Did that harm the Australian flying public, Claire?
Well, Nat, the Transport Minister's made a decision in the national interest. What
That's
I would say
I'm
to you
about.
Is there's other things happening that will increase competition.
Exactly.
At the end of the day here,
but on
we've
that
got
decision,
a very... We've got a very powerful Australian airline that has an enormously important responsibility to Australians that it is not meeting at the moment. We want lower airfare prices in this country. Qantas can make a change to that today. And we've got a new CEO at the helm, and I hope that they pick up their game
there. OK, look, with respect, you just haven't answered the question. We know what Qantas is doing. It's been on every news organisation for the last few days, but you still haven't answered the question. Jane? Well, let's talk about what's going to happen on Alan Joyce's pay. This is a big issue. The ACCC is investigating, we know. Do you think Alan Joyce should be paid his bonus?
Well, that's entirely a decision for Qantas shareholders and not something that the government should get involved in. What the government should get involved in is the decision to open up new routes to other airlines, Qatar included, that would bring down the cost of airfares for consumers. And we want to know what it is, what that decision in the national interest was, because it looks to me like it was a decision in Qantas's interest, not in consumers' interest. At a time when airfares are 50% higher than they were pre-pandemic and capacity for seats is 25% lower, you've got to explain what national interest is here, Claire. And quite frankly, Catherine King said she consulted widely, but clearly she didn't consult with you. And you're right, you do have a portfolio where the national interest is paramount. Why weren't you consulted in this decision? Why wasn't the Prime Minister consulted? What is behind Catherine King's decision here? Because consumers are paying the price.